Mehmet decapitates the advisors and lets Constantine draw his own conclusion.
We must teach the child a lesson.
Then he will taste a Roman slap.
And who will deliver that slap, pray tell? You? Mehmet is a menace. A force is not the answer. We must avoid confrontation until Catholic help arrives from Europe.
If the Catholics are our only hope, we are doomed.
The right-hand man of Constantine was Lucas Notaras. He held the position of Grand Duke, which was the equivalent of the Ottoman vizier or prime minister.
I'd rather see a sultan's turban than a cardinal's cap inside these walls.
Constantinople is the center of Orthodox Christianity. Like most of the city and the emperor's court, Notaras is Greek and Orthodox Christian and distrusts the European Catholic Church, a schism dating back four centuries. Faced with the Ottoman threat, the city desperately needs soldiers and ships from the Pope.
Low! 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 We are all brothers in the eyes of God. At this moment, we have emissaries sent to the Vatican and all the courts of Europe, securing aid for our defense. Already, there are Genoese troops bound for the city, the first of many. With God's grace, the Pope will be sending troops in the coming weeks.
Long live the Emperor!
Notaras is the wealthiest man in Constantinople. With business interests ranging from Anatolia to Italy, no one has more to lose in a war with the Ottomans.
Send this to our Turkish friend.